moving on from level one. Let's get it going right away. I'm gonna throw some different stuff at you in this video, but it's nothing I haven't done or can do. And I want you to be able to do literally anything that you want with a basketball. Let's start it up. On the last video, we did figure fours. Let's do figure eights now. Remember that the control mainly comes from your fingertips. We'll take it around both legs. We'll do 30 seconds one way and then 30 seconds the other way. Switch direction. Next up, I call him the Kyrie circle. Take the ball between the legs on the outside with one hand. We'll switch it up halfway through. Let's take a look at Kyrie actually doing it in the game. I cuff the ball when doing these type of moves. When done fast in real time, nobody can tell the difference. So I 100% teach it, mainly for control ball. Switch it. Next up, let's do the same thing, but just take the ball around the legs the opposite way. Let's take a look at another example.
There goes Irving again. Fakes the pass. What a finish by Kyrie Irving. Watson is back.
Switch. To be honest, I can go without teaching this specific move, but I don't mind it when players get a little bit flashy, long as they understand how to play the game. Most of you wouldn't have a clue who I was if I never added a little sauce on top of my moves. Next one, I call it V-dribble. With your feet planted, throw the ball between the legs, reach back, and with the same hand, dribble it back forward through the legs, and repeat it with the other hand. From an aerial view, the ball is taking a V pattern. If you can, build up on the speed. It's actually pretty easy to do. This one, we're going to slam the ball between the legs as hard as we can continuously. We're doing this mainly for control, but I do want to throw this out. My father taught me how to get steals on lazy ball handles a while back. He said wait until they start the downward dribble and attack the hand right as the ball leaves their hand, because there's nothing they can do when the ball is in midair. So I figured the longer that the ball takes to get back to the hand, the easier it is to steal. It worked for me a lot, but less against more experienced ball handlers who knew how to use their body to steal the ball. This one's kind of weird, but I'll share in the future why I added this one when we add more movement. Take the ball across the body, through the legs on the outside, then wrap it around your legs on the other side. It's a little creative, but you'll catch a rhythm, just like anything else you practice. That dribble switches on its own. Last but not least, my favorite part, create. Create with the between the legs focus in mind. Come up with whatever your mind can think of. I challenge you for 1 minute not to do the same move twice. Okay. 3, 2, 1, down. If you need some more practice, not feeling confident with it, go ahead and run this video back. If you've been on it though, I bet you're starting to feel that control coming. When you're ready to move on, I'll see you in the next video.